In this video, I'd like to talk about different methods for programming a multi-station fixture setup like our fifth axis Tombstone. There are typically two distinct methods of plane utilization for a project like this. One central offset for all parts at all locations, or a situation where every part has its own unique offset stored on the control. Typically, my preferred approach is a single offset, especially for a single five-axis part, similar to what Ben showed earlier in the cam instructor tutorial. Unless programmed to the center of rotation, one offset does require the machine to have dynamic work offsets and TCP if simultaneous five-axis motion is used. If you're looking for more information on this, we do have two older videos explaining those in depth on our computer mold series. Luckily for us, the Haas UMC machines come standard with this advanced functionality. Let's start with my preferred method using one single G54 offset. The location for the part can come from whatever location is convenient. Speaking of convenience, fifth axis does offer a 96 millimeter master gauging palette. Let's set that up in the machine. The rock lock system allows us to pull the Tombstone, install the master palette, and probe the location of the 96 millimeter rock lock pattern precisely. With that plane set up in Mastercam, the post processor and the machine control can then track all part locations from the CAD assembly and index the machine automatically with no further setup on the controller. Using the probing on the machine, I can pick up the center bore and the top surface of the palette and set it to G54. This is about as easy as it gets. Let's check out what that would look like inside a Mastercam. For simplicity, I'll demo this with a few simple contours on op 1 and 2, but Ben will show us some more advanced tool pathing in a following video. The concepts for plane creation, regardless of tool path, will be the same. Flipping to the second view sheet, notice that the top plane is set up to match how it was probed with the master palette. Whether we use the top plane or create a new plane here, it doesn't really matter. Either way, that will become our WCS and work origin. Let's go back to the first view sheet and create a tool plane for op 1 and 2. You can create these planes in whatever method you are most comfortable, but I prefer dragging the gnomon up from the lower left corner to the face of op 1. I'll set this plane to use 0 for G54. Using a single central offset means that the X, Y, Z location of this plane are not critical. The Z vector direction induces the rotation at the machine when post-processed. I'll repeat that process for a plane in op 2, again using G54. Once these planes are created, let's create a simple contour on op 1. Set the top plane as the WCS and op 1 as the CT plane. Select a contour operation using the Mitsubishi half-inch bowl end mill. On the Planes tab, notice the WCS versus Tool and Construction plane selection match the plane manager. I'll click OK and generate the toolpath. Repeat that process using the op 2 plane on the internal pocket using the 3/8 Mitsubishi IMX tool. Once complete, run a backplot of the two operations. Notice how the differing T-plane controls the vector of the tool. One advantage to using this single offset is less setup at the machine, which reduces opportunity for error. If these operations were using the same tool, you can also control the linking moves within Mastercam using multi-axis link or let the logic of the post-processor control these moves, since all the machine coordinates are relative to one location. Now let's talk about the other method that is often used on multi-station fixturing. This is where we'd have a work offset at each face and sometimes at each part. I've even seen this where different features have their own work offset. There are some advantages to this, especially on older equipment that may not be holding position as well as the parts demand. With high quality work holding like this fifth axis Tombstone, this is much less of a concern. But if the soft jaws for Op 2 were machined at an outside vendor, it's possible that the locations could be slightly different than our CAD model assembly. That could lead to a mismatch. An individual offset at this part allows the operator to compensate for that without affecting other parts or features that may be intolerance. A single offset would require us to manually adjust the model location in Mastercam. But remember, every time you make a special adjustment at the machine, the harder it will be to set up and run this job again. Not to mention, it does involve more setup for the operator from the start. The machine will need to be indicated for each face and then probe each individual component. Even on a relatively small Tombstone like this, that's 6 extra offsets and 6 extra opportunities for mistakes. It's not uncommon for Tombstones on big horizontals to have 30 plus small parts on each face, making this quite an endeavor. Lastly, the link moves between offsets are all controlled by the machine. I need to be much more careful when programming and ensure my post-processor has the proper logic to manage them. It's also important to remember that some machines don't have dynamic work offset, so you may be forced into working like this. Let's see how this method would be done in Mastercam. I already created a plane on the first part as G54. Let's make a second offset for G55 on the part. Drag the gnomon up. I'll name this Op1A and set the offset to 1 for G55. Because this will now be a WCS, it is important to have the X and Y axes aligned properly. Before creating the contour operation, set the WCS CNT plane to Op1A and create a second contour toolpath. Repeat this for one part on Op 2 using 2 for G56. Notice that each individual operation has its own work offset number. Running backplot, notice that the end results are not much different than the first method. I now need to set up G54, G55, and G56 correctly on the machine. For this project, the UMC and the fifth axis fixturing were holding position well, and the fact that these parts weren't overly critical, we took the single offset approach. This will always be my default approach. But even on this simple example, we were not getting a consistent engraved depth on Op 3 originally. Having individual offsets would have made adjusting this possible right at the control. But it wasn't a straightforward or repeatable problem, and we fixed the problem at the root cause with a better fixture design, the one you see here. We are ready to pull that master gauge, load up the Tombstone, and get back to production. This was a brief overview of planes on a part like this, and each method has its place. Sometimes a hybrid approach may even be necessary. There is no right or wrong way to get a part done. If it works, use it. But understanding the options available in Mastercam and work offsets in the control with advanced controller features like TCP and dynamic work offset allows you to balance setup complexity with the control needed for your process and parts. With that planes overview out of the way, Ben is going to walk us through some of the programming and tool paths he used on this project in the next video of this series.